Today's metal is tin, which I have bought as a handful of these cute pellets. Thanks to tin's low melting point at 232 degrees Celsius, it can be melted in a pot on a stove. On this small IKEA induction stove, it takes no more than a couple of minutes getting the metal up to temperature. In the meantime, we prepare the sand casting mold with the usual two-part cube pattern. When the lower part is filled up with casting sand, it is flipped over, letting us add the upper half of the casting flask and pattern. Now we're ready to pour the molten tin into the mold, which is a much more comfortable experience compared to pouring molten copper at 1000 degrees. The leftover is poured into a graphite mold, leaving us with a small ingot for later casts. While the cast is cooling down for half an hour, we enjoy a little break in the sun. Moment of truth. Let's see what we got. Great success. Now it's just about the cleanup and sanding the sides. With some help from my friend Adam, I got to engrave the atomic symbol for tin using the Invendibles X-Carve CNC machine. Due to tin's softness and low melting point, we did very thin and light passes. This was to avoid any melting and softening of the material while engraving it. Tin can now be added to my collection of elements and metal cubes, already consisting of copper, zinc and aluminum. Thanks for watching and see you soon.